Hi everyone. In this class, we will see about the last topic in fourth unit. It is electrical system in automobile vehicles. We already seen in yesterday's class introduction of the electrical system. In that class, we will see what are those different electrical systems in the automobile vehicles. It is charging circuit, generator, current voltage regulator, starting system, Bendix drive mechanism with a solenoid switch, lightning systems, horn, wiper, fuel gauge, oil pressure gauge, and engine temperature indicator. These are the different electrical systems in the automobile vehicles. So if you take any type of automobile vehicles, these are the basic electrical systems placed in the automobile vehicles. So we can see in this class in detail about these electrical systems. We can see first of all what is the introduction of these electrical systems. It is automobile electrical systems includes starting system, charging system, ignition system, and lightning system, and some accessories. These are the main electrical systems. We can use any type of automobile vehicles. You can take any type of automobile vehicle. These are the main electrical systems we are using. Okay, so the accessories include it is a cigarette lighter, horn, and a mobile charging system. How can we use automatically, or how can we use and how can we produce the power in mechanically by using those different instruments? Okay, and how can we start the engine automatically by using an electrical system? So we can see in this class what are the major components in the electrical, what are the major electrical components in the automobile vehicles. It is a ignition system. So in that ignition system, we are using spark plugs. So those spark plugs, we are using petrol engine, petrol vehicles, and a distributor, and ignition coils, ignition switch. These are ignition system. And next one, charging system. It is alternator, regulator, and a starting system. These are all different types of electrical systems in the automobile vehicles. Okay, so you can see what is ignition system. In spark ignition engines, the device is required to ignite the compressed air fuel mixture at the end of compression stroke. Ignition system fulfills the requirement. In the spark ignition system, there is a spark ignition system. A device is required to ignite the compressed air fuel mixture. One device is used. So that device is create a spark on that compressed air fuel mixture. Automatically the power is generated and the engine is on. Then within seconds, the engine should be running position. Automatically the power is generated on the engine. So first, what is the input and what is the main thing? It is a spark is developed on the compressed air fuel mixture. That spark is developed by using an electrical systems in the automobile vehicles. Okay, it is a part of electrical system which carries the electrical current at required voltage to the spark plug, which generates the spark at correct time. So in correct time, the spark should be generated. Suppose any type of automobile vehicle you can take, or suppose for example, I'm taking one bike. So in that bike, a self is used to create a spark on the engine. A self is used to create a spark on the engine. That means in end of the stroke, that means we can stop the bike. We can stop the engine on your bike, automatically there is the end of stroke. The compressor air fuel mixture is available, and it has through battery an electricity is passed and a spark is developed on this compressed air fuel mixture. Automatically the power is developed on the engine. So in that there is a power developed automatically, the continuous power is developed on the engine, and the engine runs very smoothly. About the different accelerations you have maintained on the running positions of your vehicle. Okay, so that is the ignition system used in the automobile vehicles. So how we generate the ignition system and what are the basic steps, you can see it consists of a battery, switch, distributor, ignition coil, spark plugs and necessary wiring. It consists of a battery. So in that any type of automobile vehicle, so the spark is developed automatically in your vehicle, a battery is used. So that battery is produces an electricity to develop a spark. It consists of a battery and switch. So the switch is used to create a spark through this distributor, ignition coil, spark plugs and necessary wiring is available. A compression ignition engine, diesel engine, does not require any ignition system. So there is no ignition system. There are separate setup we are using in that compression ignition engines. Because of self-ignition of fuel air mixture takes place when diesel is injected in the compressed air at high temperatures at the end of the compression stroke. Because of self-ignition of fuel air mixture, it takes place when diesel is injected in the compressed air at high temperature at the end of compression stroke. In the compression ignition system, the end of the stroke compression has very high temperature. Okay, so it is a self-ignition. Just a small power is transferred to the end of the compression stroke of the compressed air. Automatically the spark is developed. What are the requirements? What are the requirements of these ignition systems? You can see so the ignition system should be capable of producing high voltage current, as it is 25,000 volts, so that the spark plug can produce a spark across its electrode gap. It should produce a spark for sufficient duration so that the mixture can be ignited at all operating speeds of automobile. So the ignition system should be capable of producing high voltage current. So in that ignition system, it will produce so much amount of that means high amount of voltage is transferred to that transfer lines of the ignition system. As high as 25,000 volts should be generated, so that spark plug can produce spark across its electrode gap. There is an electrode gap, automatically the spark is developed. It should produce spark for sufficient duration so that mixture can be ignited at all operating speeds of automobile. It should produce spark for sufficient duration so that mixture can be ignited at all operating speeds of automobile. And ignition system should function satisfactory at all engine speeds. Ignition system should function satisfy the all engine speeds. So the ignition system is very important. The we can generate a power automatically on any type of automobile vehicles. So the ignition system is very important. It is satisfy the all engine speeds. Longer life of contact points and spark plug. A spark must generate at correct time at the end of compression stroke in every cycle of engine operation. The system must be easy to maintain, light in weight and compact in size. These are the different requirements of the ignition systems. You can see what are the types of ignition system. There is a battery ignition system or coil ignition system. And a magneto ignition system and electronic ignition system. These are the different types of ignition systems we are used in the automobile vehicles. In battery ignition system, the current in the primary winding supplied in a battery, whereas it is supplied by a magneto in magneto ignition system. battery ignition system is used in cars and light truck. Magneto ignition system is used in some scooters. Both the systems work on the principle of mutual electromagnetic induction. Electronic ignition systems use solid state devices such as transistors and capacitors. These are the types of ignition system. You can see the diagram of the battery ignition system. It is the battery ignition system. What are the components of the battery ignition system? There is a battery. In that battery, we are connected with a ammeter. Those ammeter is connected with the ignition switch. That ignition switch is connected to the primary winding. In that primary winding, we can place a coil on the primary wire, primary winding and secondary winding. This primary winding is connected to primary coil is connected to the contact breaking points and condenser. There is a condenser and contact breaking point. And next, secondary coil is connected to the two spark plugs and distributor. Okay, so these are the ignition circuit for a four-cylinder engine. It is the ignition circuit for four-cylinder engines. You can see what are the main components in this battery ignition system. 6 to 12 volts battery and ammeter and ignition switch, ignition coil, circuit or contact breaker, cam and condenser, distributor and spark plugs. These are the main components in the battery ignition system. You can see the construction and working of this battery ignition system. The system employs a 6 to 12 volt battery for the supply of low tension current. So in this battery should supply the low voltage current. One terminal of the battery is connected to the frame of the engine and the other is connected to the primary terminal of the ignition coil through an ammeter and ignition system. So there is a battery system. In that battery systems has two coils. Two terminals. One terminal is connected to the ammeter and another terminal is connected to the engine. And then another terminal is connected to the engine. So in the other terminal that is connected with the ammeter, that is the primary terminal of the ignition coil through an ammeter and ignition switch. So the ignition switch can be turned on or off with the help of ignition switch. And the switch is placed within easy reach of the driver. The ignition coil consists of primary and secondary coils wound on a soft iron core. So the primary coil and secondary coil wound on a soft iron core. The primary winding has a small number of turns of thick wire and the secondary winding has a large number of turns with thin wire. Primary winding has a small number of turns with thick wire. And the secondary winding has a large number of turns with thin wire. You can observe the diagram. Okay, you can observe this primary coil and secondary coil. You can observe what I am told. The primary coil, primary winding, primary coil is wound with a small number of turns with thick wire, and secondary winding has a large number of turns with thin wire. Whereas one terminal of the primary winding connects to the battery, the other terminal is connected to the end of the contact points of the circuit breaker and from the closed points to the earth. So it is apparently the primary circuit of the ignition coil gets completed when contact points of the circuit breaker are held together and the ignition switch is closed. When the contact breaker is a spring control switch and it is operated by means of a cam lobes of the cam corresponded to the number of cylinders and a four-stroke cycle engine, the cam is motored at half the engine speed. The contact breaker breaks the primary circuits for each cylinder during one complete cycle of engine. It consider a condenser is connected to parallel with the contact breaker unit and it functions to provide reservoir for current. A ballast resistor is connected in series with the primary circuit of the ignition coil and it regulates the current flow to a safe value and prevents the overheating of the coil. So distributor and the spark plugs of a multi-cylinder engine, a high tension cable connects the secondary coil to the distributor, and from the distributor the cables are connected to the all spark plugs. In this procedure, automatically the spark is developed on the engine, and the engine should be running continuously about this procedure. Okay, so it is the battery ignition system. What are its advantages? You can see a low initial cost, better spark at low speeds, and better starting than magneto system, reliable system, no problems due to adjustment of spark timing, simple than magneto system. Disadvantages, you can see battery requires periodical maintenance in case of battery malfunctioning, engine cannot be started. And you can see the same working principle of the magneto system. These are the different components of the magneto ignition system. Then there are spark plugs, distributor, coil, cam, and contact breaker, ignition switch, and capacitor. There is a primary winding and secondary winding, rotating magnet. There is a rotating magnet is difference between the battery ignition system and the magneto ignition system. The magnet is rotating magnet is placed in the coil of the magneto ignition system. And next you can see the advantages of the magneto ignition system. It is better reliability due to absence of the battery and low maintenance, better suited for medium and high speed engines. Modern magneto systems are more compact, therefore require less space. And disadvantages, adjustment of spark timings adversely affects the voltage, burning of electrodes is possible at a high engine speeds due to high voltage, cost is more than that of magneto ignition systems. What is the comparison between battery ignition and magneto ignition? It offers better spark at low speeds, starting and for cranking purpose. More reliable as there is no battery and cable connections in magneto ignition system. In battery ignition system, initial cost is high. Magneto ignition system, more suitable for medium and very high speed engines. Reliable system need periodic maintenance. Less space is required. High speed engine drive is usually simpler. At a low speed, voltage is low, so not good in a slow speed case. With increasing speeds, sparking voltage drops. The power sparks at high engine speeds cause burning of the electrodes. Because of the battery bulk of the system is high. These are the comparison between the battery ignition and magneto ignition system. And you can see electrical ignition system also. Battery switch and ignition coil, electronic control unit. So the electronic control is placed in the electronic ignition system, and armature, sensor coil, and the ignition coil is connected to the distributor. These distributors have connected to the spark plugs. Okay, it is a electronic ignition system. Okay. Next, need of a spark advance retard mechanism. What are the different mechanisms of the spark ignition systems and the spark plugs? Okay. So in the spark advanced mechanism, there is a centrifugal advance and a vacuum advance are the two general methods used in the modern engines to advance and retard the ignition timing automatically in relation to engine speed and operating conditions after the initial timing is set. One is a centrifugal advance spark mechanism and the vacuum advance mechanism. Okay. These are the two different types of advanced mechanisms used in the spark plugs. Okay. centrifugal spark advance mechanism. It is the centrifugal spark advance mechanism. You can see the constructional details of the centrifugal advance mechanism. In this centrifugal advance mechanism, depends upon the principle of centrifugal force and provides ignition advance according to the engine speed. So in this mechanism, it consists of two flyweights. It is a cam, cross piece, and a base plate. Cam, you can see the parts. Cam, cross piece, and base plate. You can see the base plates. These are the base plates. Okay. It is, these are the cam. Okay, so in this centrifugal advance, the spring is loaded, flyweights are of varying weight. It's their ends, and the weights are pivoted onto the cross piece, means pegs, but are free on the other end. These weights are also attached to the base plate through the coil springs, and the base plate is fixed to the drive shaft. The cam is also connected. You can see the cam. The cam is also connected with the base plate. As the engine speed increases, the fly weights are subjected to centrifugal force and fly out while doing so. The weights and its turn about their fulcrum. It consequently, the cross piece also experiences small movement turns the cam and a rotor arm. So it has a lack of power during acceleration and increase of fuel consumption and exhaust emissions. It constant knocking sound at low speeds due to the over advanced ignition with the over advanced ignition system. The cranking is also becomes slow and jerky. It is the overall working procedure of the centrifugal spark and advanced mechanism. Okay. Next, vacuum advanced mechanism. These are also same working procedure compared to the spark advanced mechanism. You can see the constructional details of the vacuum advanced mechanism. There is an intake manifold and an airflow vacuum chamber and vacuum tubes, a diaphragm. Okay. And operating rods, timing lever, spring. You can see this vacuum advanced diaphragm. These are the advanced. It is the vacuum advanced diaphragm, vacuum lines, distributor, braking plates, part throttle, that is the intake manifold. Okay. And carburetor, air horn. These are the different constructional details of the vacuum advanced mechanism. Next, you can see standard Bendix drive mechanism. You can see the different constructional details of the standard Bendix drive mechanism. There is a starting motor, armature shaft, collar, ring gear, flywheel, and a threaded sleeve, unbalanced weight, torsion spring, sliding rocks, keys, and a stationary drive head. These are the components of the standard drive, Bendix drive mechanism. In the Bendix drive with the compression spring. So it has a compression spring, main compression spring. You can see the diagram. Main compression spring. It is the main compression spring in the Bendix drive mechanism. Starting motor, armature, auxiliary compression spring, pinion, and a threaded sleeve with the main compression spring. There's a nut, splined armature shaft, and it has a ring gear. That ring gear, you can see the flywheel. Okay. Next, a follow through starting drive mechanism, overrunning clutch drive mechanism, wiring circuit for cutout relay. And it is the spark plug. It is the spark plug, and these are the constructional details of the spark plug. There is a terminal lead, leakage current bearings, and central electrodes, ceramic insulation, rust resistant shell, special conductive seal, threads, internal seal. There is a spark gap. So the spark is developed in this gap and the ground electrode. These are the constructional details of the spark plate.
So the spar cap is generally kept between 0.6 mm to 1 mm. Too large or too small gap has an adverse effect on the efficiency of the ignition system. The sparking voltage at the spark plug is 10,000 to 15,000 volts and it lasts for about 0.001 second. In this time, the spark is developed. So the materials used in the construction of different parts of the spark plugs are steel and insulation. You can see porcelain, mica, and sintered aluminum. And what type of electrode we are using? Nickel, alloy of nickel and manganese, and manganese with silicon platinum alloys are used in the making of electrodes. So these are the different constructional details of the spark plug. And you can see hot and cold spark plugs. These are the types of spark plugs, hot spark plug and cold spark plug. And you can see what is the headlamp construction. There is a filament shield, filament glass reflector, aluminized glass lens. And you can see horn circuit. These are the constructional details of the horn circuit. There is a different constructional details. There is a air column, and you can see the diaphragm, striker plate, tone disc, sound duct and armature, laminated magnet, guide spring, solenoid winding, contact breaker, terminals. These are the constructional details of the horn. Horn circuit with relay. You can see the horns and horn relays and horn switch. Whenever the horn switch is on, automatically the sound is coming about these horn speakers. Okay. Next, windscreen wipers. So a mechanical linkages and mechanical mechanism is used to operate a windscreen wiper through battery connection. Through battery connection or through electricity is used to run a wiper on any type of automobile vehicles. You can see the constructional details of the wiper. There is a worm wheel, link arm, worm bearings, armature shaft, wiper motor, and fulcrum. This fulcrum is connected with the link arm. And this fulcrum also connects with the wheel sector. This wheel sector is connected with the wheel box. These wheel box are connected with the wiper arms. The wiper arms is placed in the wiper arms are connected with the wiper blades. These wiper blades are placed in the mirror of the automobile vehicles. Okay, these are the constructional details. And a fuel gauge. So the fuel gauge is also runs with the help of electrical system in the automobile vehicles. You can see the constructional details of the fuel gauge. There is a battery connected with the ignition switch. This ignition switch is connected to the coil of the armature. There is an armature connection and armature bearing. There is a pole piece. This pole piece is connected to the rheostat, and there is a contact point with a float arm. There is a float, that means in the fuel tank a float is placed. The float is connected with the float arm in the contact position of the rheostat. So it will shows the what is the fuel tank level about this digital meter or any other devices we are used in the automobile vehicles. Okay, these are the constructional details of the fuel gauge. And you can see the temperature gauge.
you can see the temperature gauge. These are the constructional details of the temperature gauge.
These are the temperature indicator of the automobile vehicles. You can see the constructional details of the temperature gauge. The ignition system, the ignition switch is connected to the battery, and ignition switch is connected to the heater. There is a heater setup. Heater coil is connected with the ignition switch. And there is a different constructional details. You can see the bimetal strips and pointer. These bimetal strips are connected to the fixed and mobile contact resistance. It is connected to the terminal, and there is a heater coil and bimetal strips. So it is the temperature gauge and automatic air conditioning system. So how the air conditioning system is works on the automobile vehicles?
Based upon these constructional details and setup, you can see there is a battery setup. In that battery, fan, AC, heater. There is a magnetic clutch. You can see this magnetic clutch. This magnetic clutch is connected to the condenser drain. This condenser drain is connected to the temperature sensor. And this magnetic clutch is connected to the compressor. It has the high pressure vapor is passing through the condenser, and the low pressure vapor is passed through the evaporator. Okay, it is the evaporator. The low pressure vapor is passed through the evaporator, and the high pressure vapor is passed through the condenser. So it has high pressure liquid and receives the dryer, strainer, and side gloss. You can see the evaporator coming off the low pressure liquid is passed through the expansion valve. Okay, so it is both are in the side glass. You can see the temperature sensors. It is capillary tube. There is a fan or AC or heater is connected to that temperature sensors to the condenser, evaporator. The fan, AC or heater is connected to the evaporator. Then we use the automatic air conditioning system in the automobile vehicles. Okay. Next one, battery. So the functions of battery to supply heavy current required to the starter motor for starting the engine, to supply the current to lamps, radio and other accessories when the engine is not running, to act as a stabilizer to the voltage in the electrical system. So it is the batteries. These are the different types of batteries: primary cells, secondary cells, wet charged and dry charged, and low maintenance. These are the different types of batteries we are used in the automobile vehicles. So you can see the dry cell battery. It is connected through the one end is connected through the light bulb first end, and the other end is connected to the light bulb second end. You can see the constructional details of the dry cell battery. There is a carbon positive electrode. It is cathode and electrolyte paste separator, carbon magnetics, dioxide mixture, zinc negative electrode anode. Zinc is the negative electrode anode. So these are the constructional details of the dry cell battery. And lead cell, lead acid cell. There is a anode is the lead dioxide, cathode is the porous lead, electrolyte is the sulfuric acid. During discharging, there is a negative plate reaction. You can see the reaction, positive plate reaction. You can see the reaction. So how much of battery capacity you can maintain in the automobile vehicles? The amount of electricity of a battery will deliver within a certain time limit. It is known as a capacity of ampere hour capacity. The amount of current furnished by the battery depends upon the following factors: number of plates of battery, area of plate surface in contact with the electrolyte, quality of electrolyte, temperature. These are the different factors are based upon the depends upon the battery capacity.
And you can checking the batteries for voltage and specific gravity test, and a high rate discharge test, and open circuit voltage test, and cadmium test. These are the different tests we can check the batteries for under voltage and specific gravity. Causes of battery failure, you can see electrolyte level, under charging, overcharging, temperature, corrosion, cycling. These are the causes of battery failures. Okay, so it is overall about the electrical system in the automobile vehicles. So thank you guys. Next class we will start a new unit in this automobile unit subject. So thank you guys.